Hey, Dusty Jameson with Inspector Clouseau. Wanted to take a video real quick and show you some radon detection devices. Wanted to speak specifically on devices. There's a lot of stuff that we could talk about with radon testing, procedures, protocols, locations, all of that. I don't want to go down that avenue today. Want to speak specifically on the devices and especially radon devices in relation to real estate transactions. I've actually got three monitors that we use for my company, our professional monitors, and then I've got a couple of homeowner type monitors that I wanted to show you. I'll run you through the monitors real quick and then speak on the differences and what we should be seeing with real estate transaction versus what could be done. So real quick, Sun Nuclear 1028 XP, that's this device, Sun Nuclear 1027, and then the Corentium Pro. These are our professional devices that we use for our company. We've actually got 12 professional monitors that we use for real estate transaction testing. These devices, this is the AirThings Wave, and then this is the AirThings 223. I'll tell you the difference about these monitors in just a second, but let's talk specifically on the professional monitors first. These monitors, these have sensors in them, so when we operate or when we do a real estate transaction, we're running a radon test, we're going to check for a specific period of time, generally between 2 and 5 days with these devices is what we're using them for. They have sensors in that can tell us if the box is picked up and moved. For instance, this 1027, it's actually running right now. If I pick this up and move it, when I plug that device into the computer and I get the printout of the readings for the past 48 hours, it will show me a little, I think it's a T, tampering. It will show me that box was tampered with, it was moved. The 1028 and the Corentium Pro, those have not only movement sensors, but those have sensors for air pressure, temperature, and humidity as well. Those are just more sensors to help us monitor and track what was going on during the duration of the test. That is why these are professional devices. They have to have some sort of way where the person performing the test can go back and look and make sure, to the best of our ability, that nothing was tampered with those tests. Now, Tennessee is not a regulated state in meaning that there's no law that tells us we have to follow a specific protocol, however, our company or anybody performing a test, we should be following a national standard. The American Association of Radon Scientists and Technologies, they have a protocol. They actually have a list of approved devices to follow that protocol. So if us, Inspector Clouseau, if we're going to perform a radon test, then we want to follow the protocol that gives us the most accurate measurement. And with doing that, we have to use an approved device. That's these devices. These devices at the back, these are really good. And I ran every one of these devices ran over the weekend at my house performing a radon test. All of them came back in the same range. They weren't exact. There was a little bit of variation. My house has a pre-plumbed radon pipe, which means it's got a pipe that's already in the slab going through the roof. I've got that in place and I've monitored my house for 6 months now. This device has been in my house for 6 months. So I know that I've got naturally a low reading, but it hovers right around one. That's what I'm getting at, is it hovers right around one. The last 48 hours, all of the devices were between 0.7 and 0.4, all of them. The one that actually read a little bit different was the Corentium Pro. That's where we could go down a rabbit hole of, we typically put this on a tripod and we run this test while it's on a tripod. If I've got it sitting on a desk, it's gonna read a little bit different. So that could be some of the nuance on why that one read different. But all of that to say, they were all in the same, in the realm, same realm, the same range. And especially the ones that are much cheaper, the homeowner style devices, they were there too. Now, the reason that we can't use these for real estate transaction testing is because, let's say for instance, if my son took this device and he threw it outside, a couple of days later he went and got it and brought it back inside, if I came home and I just read the readout on the face of this, I wouldn't be able to tell if anything happened to that device for those past 2 days. And let's say it read high, let's say it shot up to 7 or 8. If it shot to 7 or 8 picocuries per liter, then it's over the limit that we're supposed to be at. but it was sitting outside. Now, obviously, that probably wouldn't be the case, but I'm just giving you an example that you can't track these devices. If anybody is doing a real estate transaction or doing a radon test during a real estate transaction, we need to get the closest thing to a perfect test, and that's impossible, but we need to get the closest thing to that perfect test that we can. And that first step starts with having an approved device. So we shouldn't be using these for real estate transactions, even though they may be accurate. We shouldn't be using them because we can't track their readings over the course of the test. These devices we can. Now these devices, this one was $1,000. I think these are somewhere around $700 or $800. This one is about $1,000 too. This is $200. This is $150. So if you're a homeowner just looking to monitor radon, especially long-term, I love this device. You can hook up to it Bluetooth. I've monitored mine with this device for my house. I've monitored it for 6 months with this one, and I love it. It shows me really good, accurate measurements. I compare it a lot of times. If I've got a weekend where we're not using certain monitors, I'll bring them in and just do some comparison testing, just like I did this past weekend. And they're always, everything's always dead on. These devices also have to be calibrated annually too. That's part of the having an approved device. It has to, once a year, get shipped off to make sure that its calibration is correct too. So those are the boxes we should be seeing for real estate transaction. If you're seeing anything other than this style of box, then you probably should question it. There are other professional devices that are approved that don't look exactly like this. So don't get me wrong, there are other variations that you can use, but we shouldn't be seeing these cheaper models to be used for real estate transactions. So if you're seeing that, then you can legitimately question the accuracy of that test because there's no way to track those results. So hope that helps give you some information on what devices should be used. There's a lot more that we could talk about with radon testing. Like I mentioned, protocols, testing locations. Really, we could get broader and talk about radon in general, and in terms of a two-day test versus long-term test, the accuracy there. There's a whole conversation to be had with that, but that's not what we're getting into today. Today, the main focus was the device and what we should be seeing during real estate transactions. Hopefully, it's a professional device that is approved. If not, you need to question that. If there's anything I can answer for you, feel free to reach out. Thanks for watching.